بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I'm Ibrahim Gangat and this is Salam Media. Today we are going to be talking about a topic that has troubled many people, perhaps in Africa, maybe around the globe, but more especially in South Africa. Many people from the African continent came to South Africa away from troubled areas like Somalia and many other countries in Africa, just to find that they are almost back in the same situation where they're going to great amount of difficulties and problems. To help us unpack all of that today, we have our special guest with us in the studio. He is Brother Amir Sheikh, Chairman of the Somali Community Board. He's also a Director of the Southern African Migrants and Refugee Council and also the Chief Operating Officer of Township Business Development SA. We're going to ask him to explain to us what exactly is happening in South Africa. Welcome him to the program. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Brother Amir.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, Brother Ibrahim.
Jazakallah khairan so much for your time. It seems to be a complicated situation. Many people from Africa at the time when South Africa got their freedom thought, well, this is the haven. This is where we could go to after having so much of difficulty where we are going through war-torn situations and refugees and whatever else. They then came to South Africa. But it would appear that it's all back to the same. How can we best start defining this particular issue? How should we understand it as South Africans?
Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much, and to Salam Media for giving me this opportunity to also unpack this issue that is now becoming a thorn in the neck, the issue of xenophobia in South Africa, or lack of coexistence among the mainstream South Africans and the migrant community. With the specific case on the Somali, a country that have been in turmoil for over 25 years now, two decades and a half. So the situation of the common Somali businessman in South Africa is like actually from a frying pan to fire. We cannot go back due to the situation that there is instability in the country, and the country that we have actually sought refuge, the situation of the Somalis in South Africa, is that one actually that is reported on daily basis, which is actually killing, looting, maiming, and etc.
So if we try to understand, many of the people ask the question, why doesn't the people from Somalia, many of them become employees, go and work for other people? What we have found to be a very distinct feature is Somalian people like to do business, mm-hmm. and together with all of that, they then find themselves in an area where many of our local indigenous people live, or the township area where they do business. And this is basically the area where the problem starts. Mm-hmm. So how do you explain, you know, the culture maybe and the most distinct features of Somalian people as business people?
There is actually a saying of the Prophet salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi, al-yadul uliya khayru min al-yadul sufla. And the hand of the Muslim must always be the upper hand and not the lower hand. I'm saying this because you cannot actually come from actually a desperate situation to only find yourself in another desperate situation where you are begging for basic essential needs. So we have no option. The only option we have and the funding model that our members can get is the one that will take them to the most impoverished communities in order to start a life from there. And by going to the most impoverished communities in the informal settlement and the townships, we find high crime rate, we actually find high unemployment rate among actually the youth, and this is actually leading actually to this unrest that we see most of the time. But in order to actually better that, we need to actually find a model where we can coexist with our brothers that we have sought refuge within, in order actually to coexist. And in that way is why we formed the Township Business Development, which is led by Maulana Abbas Mukize, a native of South Africa, with the aim of actually bridging the gap between the migrant and the local so that we can come together, hold hands together, partner in business. And alhamdulillah, within 1 year and a half, we have now signed an agreement with the Minister of Small Business Development, which Salam Media actually covered extensively. And in that way, we will actually see, inshallah, a change in the way we are dealing with our presidents.
Yes, absolutely. We always hope for the best and pray that Allah Ta'ala makes it easy. But when we look at some of the issues on hand, just for the people to understand, what are some of the main issues that leads to sometime the riots, the looting? They talk about Somalian businessmen shooting, people and so forth. But what are the most common, you know, that makes us understand, okay, this is actually what takes place? Paint us a scenario.
Okay, in the most informal settlements and township where we actually boot our business, the underlying factors I mentioned is actually the high crime rate, the high unemployment rate among the locals, most productive actually the youth. But the inability of our law enforcement to also contain the situation led to this. I'm saying that there is nothing that will have forced a Somali national to have an illegal firearm if he is actually protected adequately himself and his businesses. But we have seen that at least the police in their full regalia and in their actually might are not doing much to alleviate. We have seen shops being looted and the law enforcement themselves taking part in the lootings. And these have actually forced some, but not all of us, a certain numbers actually to arm themselves so that they can protect themselves and their businesses. And we have seen with that actually the end result was not good, because a certain person will actually use the illegal firearm, but the whole community will riot and all shops, irrespective of the nationalities, will actually be looted.
And do the Somalian community of businessmen give back to the community? If they do, how do they do that?
Alhamdulillah, they do give back, and we give out in many ways. One of the ways that we give us actually to organize the Somalis in wherever respective jurisdiction they will be, to work closer with the civic organizations as well as actually their ward councillors. You know, the ward councillors actually run the indigent funds, where a person, if he's unable to bury his own, or there are children who cannot go to school, they assist. And in that way, we assist the local community on any project that actually they bring, the ward councillors, the committee members, we always support. But one other thing we started recently is actually the skills and the entrepreneurship actually exchange programs, and working in partnership with certain humanitarian and organization like the South African National Zakat Fund. Inshallah, what we are looking forward is to see more of actually the local impoverished communities actually trained as entrepreneurs. We are also doing this with the Small Business Development Ministry, and inshallah, what we foresee is actually khair. Shukran.
Jazakumullah khair. And then that was Brother Amir Sheikh, and in a very progressive movement, the Township Business Development SA. He is together with Maulana Abbas Mkize, and they're really trying to patch things up in South Africa, wherever they are. So the next time you read a report of perhaps some sort of looting, whatever is taking place around the country, remember one of the senior leaders of the Somalian community, Brother Amir Sheikh, has given us a lot of hope that things are, and inshallah, will certainly come right in our country, South Africa. Until next time, from myself, Ibrahim Gangad, and Salam Media, fi amanillah, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.